But all right, here we go. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a BJ & Co. cast of Division 3 Chair League, ProtoMen vs. Die for Vision. How you doing, Ben?
I'm doing good. Yourself, Sammy?
You know, can't complain. We're here. We're playing some heroes and watching heroes because we can't play. We suck. Let's get real.
Yeah.
So, yeah, what's going on? What do we have ahead of us here?
So, we're just got the draft up right now. The match is going to be on Tomb of the Spider King. Queen? Jesus. And I can't even read tonight. It's great.
We don't see gender here at BJ & Co.
So, right off the bat, we have ProtoMen first banning a Tracer. Thoughts?
I mean, to me, that would mean that they're going for a melee, melee build.
I was going to say, she can really shut down some of the melee heroes, so I would definitely agree with you there. But all in all, even if you've got a ranged comp, she can just piss people off way too much.
She's pretty annoying. So, you know, she seems to be one that if Li Ming and Kalthus aren't picked, she seems to be picked quite regularly.
This also kind of leads me to believe that they want a Li Ming or Kalthus in their team.
Interesting. Illidan.
Illidan.
These aren't the... Yeah, there's the Kalthus right there.
Well, in this level, little out from 30 level hero league, people want to play these heroes, right? Yeah. And the Li Ming first pick too. Very expected. Zul has great lane clear. I like him on this map. Both Kalthus and Li Ming have decent wave clear as well. So they're all really good pickups, and all of them are great for the team fights too. Zul with a nice Poison Nova in the midst of everything is great. That lockdown with his Bone Prism as well. It's pretty hot.
Yeah, it's. It's been a while since I've seen a ban like Tracer Illidan, but I don't mind it. It mixes it up. It's not the regular battle meta.
But they're still, I would say they're both top assassins still, which is
good. For sure. For sure.
So Malfurion is healer from ProtoMen.
Interesting.
I'm guessing they're going for a lot of... They're worried about spread damage.
Right.
Instead of point damage, if that, like, heavy burst. Which is interesting. I don't know how it's going to work out against Li Ming and Azul.
Mm-hmm. Rainer, he's there. He's always just kind of putzing around. Nothing too crazy there. Mm-hmm. He's good, though. He's good for zoning.
Yeah. ETC ban. And can stand up on his own a little bit, which is nice.
Yeah.
ETC ban, he's a very top-level tank. He positionally can do a lot, especially with his mosh pit, lock people down and just allow them to be bursted up. A mosh pit with a disintegrate behind it, GG.
Oh, for sure. That would just storm. And Morales, which, I mean, they could have went tank or support. So, I mean, Morales is kind of annoying if you can't get to her. Mind you, they don't have a lot of front line, so it's interesting.
Yeah. I think it's good. Li Ming can definitely keep a tank very easily sustained. And with the Johanna pickup, I could see that pairing being a little bit deadly to them.
Well, yeah, because Johanna, she's pretty... sustainable as well, so
exactly, she's sustainable plus the heals on her. Great wave clear for this map too, right? Being able to pull the spiders towards her. A Nazebo, a second specialist pickup. I like me some Naz. There's some neat, really neat walls and tight quarters on here that his spirit works really well over. I don't see Naz being played quite a bit, so it'll be interesting to see how he's changed since I used to wreck with him.
I don't think it's terrible, because if they can just get lane presence and destroy the waves, there's not a, you know, they can get those spider queens, right?
Most definitely. Stitches for a tank. Depending on how things go, I'm pretty sure support's coming on the side of Die for Vision.
I would hope.
If Stitches can just pull Johanna out of the fight, it'll leave the rest of them very exposed.
Right, so do you aim for Johanna, or do you pull a Li Ming?
Well, I would say or a Zul. If you're trying to hook, you're trying to hook a Li Ming, Zul, Nazebo, anything along that lines. But
Greymane, that's all right.
This is a very interesting comp with the one support, one tank, and three damage. And I think the Malfurion pick fits nicely with that, in that they're going to have three people taking damage steadily, right, with the three assassins.
Right.
That the Tranquility will do very good at keeping them alive and in the fight when they would normally be a little bit squishier with some of the other heroes that doesn't quite have that sustained heal that Malfurion does.
So now support. Who are they gonna pick the die for Vision?
Rengar? My gut says Rengar, but there's not a lot of lightning targets. You've got Johanna, but she's good with it. You know, with her ability to condemn everybody in and a lightning shield on her to do damage, it can be a great... But Lili, not a bad one.
I mean, yeah.
Puts a little bit of the blinds and stuff out, which can be nice against some of these characters, especially if Greymane's coming in on it. So that's what we've got, guys. That is our draft.
At that point, make sure you place your bets.
Yep.
Bet your BJs. You still have 8 minutes. Exclamation point, bet A for ProtoMen or bet B for Die for Vision.
Are you placing any bets?
You know.
And it's what, A for ProtoMen?
A for ProtoMen. All right. Wow, look at you. Okay. All right. All right. I'll play this game. I'll play it. Boop, boop, boop. Oh. Okay, well, now what?
You bet for who you want.
Well, I'm as BJ and Co, so I can't bet for anyone.
Oh, shit.
But that's who I was going to bet for, just to mix it up. So, thanks, Ben, for betting for me.
You're welcome.
All right, well, here goes a thing.
A thing. We're still waiting on everybody just to ready up, so we'll...
Jerks.
We'll go.
So, which team comp do you... enjoy more?
I like the... I'm intrigued and interested to see how ProtoMen do. With this three assassin comp that I don't really see much, I think it'll work out. Like, Stitch is a very sustained tank that I think will do well in the front line. There's not super burst on... Well, you got the Li Ming. But I think it'll do well. I think Stitch will be able to zone well enough for the two range and the one assassin that it will be very interesting. Break things, time to wreck stuff. I like it.
How you doing, break things? Beautiful.
Joe's gone.
Time to get wrecked. Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. Shit.
Yeah. So. Oh. Yeah, I'm interested to see how the double specialist goes.
Okay, and it looks like everybody is good. 10 out of 10. Starting game.
It's a little unbalanced with the bets. But get your bets in. You still have 6 minutes. Bet A for ProtoMen. Bet B for Die for Vision.
So how unbalanced is it now?
Well, we currently have 1,168. Correction, 1,318 for ProtoMen and 1,000 for Die for Vision.
Nice. It's
so
little on the side of ProtoMen, but I like how there's the good sized parts. We've got, oh man, Joe Jr. You're disappointing us, man.
Why?
What happened? He's the only one that's not a combined portraits. Come on. That gets savvy off a little bit. But so as we start, guys, here on the left hand side, the blue side, we have the ProtoMen with Doom Monkey on Stitches, Desert Fox on Raynar, Jurjur on Kel'Thas, Colonel Ron on Malfurion, and Kanuka Maku in Greymane. And Ben, Savvy's gonna be very happy.
They did the thing.
They ran around. Very happy to see them running around. That's very awesome. And on the red side, guys, with Die for Vision, we've got Handsome Man on Zul, Jojo Jr. on Lili, Zeus on Johanna, Kerrigan on Nazebo, and Break Things on Li Ming. So this should be good.
Welcome. Spontaneous, you can type exclamation point. Who cares? You'll figure it out.
BJ's.
We got a game to cast.
Yeah.
So they went middle.
Yeah, so we've got 4 versus 3 middle. Triple assassin on the side. Ooh, whiffed hook, man.
Oh my gosh, Li Ming. She's taking some damage. We have Nazebo down bottom just doing his thing, which is interesting.
Yeah.
I mean, he can push. He is hiding because he's scared. But,
yeah.
Raynor's heading down there to help him. Zul went top with a Greymane. That's interesting. They put both specialists alone. And I think with Die for Vision, they're just going to keep three in the middle
mm-hmm.
to force a one-on-one, at least, I would assume.
Yeah. Well, and you see, what I find very interesting here is that Zul is doing the rotation. Very often on this map, you see a rotation of a one and four, with the fours rotating between two lanes to clear the gems. But it looked like just Zul was doing that for the side of Die for Vision.
Interesting. He has gone back up top. It's, I mean, nothing's, you know, ProtoMen hit level two first, but it's still pretty early. Nothing major's happened.
Yeah, there's no major change. There's not any massive kills that have been given a significant lead yet. No lanes being pushed hard enough, I'd say, to take out towers, though we've got ammo going down pretty hard on the side of ProtoMen up at the top.
Right, you know, with Zul up there doing his thing, that's going to happen.
Yeah, those skeletons will just take so many shots from the towers on top of the regular minions.
Like, I don't think a Kalthus is going to be able to take an Azebo. I just don't think he can get, you know, he's got range, but I don't think he can get close enough.
Yeah, Azebo's no, an Azebo balls. Can poke from his distance well enough that he should be able to stay safe if he's playing properly.
We do have Kalthus coming up from the bottom to hit Johanna. Oh, no, that's not Dead Zul. All right. Okay, my eyes are going. I'm getting old. What can I say?
Yeah. But again, this mid lane is staying very pushed right to the middle, which is great to see. They're both holding their own very well. I feel like as the levels take off, it might cause some more issues for the side of Die for Vision. Just as the burst potential from ProtoMen picks up.
It is weird that ProtoMen is definitely... They seem to be... Oh, I take that back. I was going to say ProtoMen were ahead in the level, but it seems to have evened up with Die for Vision catching up very quickly. Mm-hmm. So, yes.
But with the wave clear from ProtoMen, like you saw Jurjur come in, drop the flame strike, cleared it out about halfway, and they're able to back out, get back to the fight in mid, and keep that pressure up against the mid lane.
Which it looks like the Lili... for Die for Vision has gone up top, which has left a bit of a void in the center lane, which is interesting. Mm-hmm. But they're all coming back to continue that fight, it seems like. Stitch has gone up, getting a bit of a turn in from Nazebo, and Zul just back off. Whoa, whiffed.
Well, Nazebo did a good job of staying away from that one.
Yeah, it was a nice little juke. Going after Malfurion, which you gotta do, but not enough damage, not quick enough, as ProtoMen's team comes in.
Mm-hmm. But it's looking like ProtoMen is making some turn-ins on their side. If they can get...
they just turn in.
Yeah, if they can get Stitches and one other turned in, they'll have it. But it's picking up on the side of Die for Vision as well, too. It'll be very close for the first turn-in. One shy on ProtoMen's side.
That hurts. Hey, look, Malfurion, you have one. You should turn it in. Will Stitches get the hook?
Yeah. No hook, but yes for the turn-in.
Yeah, got the turn-in, which is good. That helps ProtoMen. They've got a little bit of a level lead. We'll see what happens for sure. No deaths yet.
No deaths. Awesome. I don't know if you... Whoa! Oh, Stitches is down.
That hurts. Spoke too soon.
I was going to commend Doom Monkey on his body blocking of the Kalthus heart back in the middle, just to make sure Li Ming didn't interrupt that on him.
Right.
But you got taken out a little bit after, which is kind of disappointing.
Yeah, you know, that's too bad. It definitely, it didn't really give Die for Vision much of a level lead, which is, you thought it was terrible, so.
Bad at games.
But the Spider Queens are going to town on the towers, which is definitely going to help.
Well, towers up top, but both everything mid and else bottom are going to be taken out before they do anything.
Yeah. And now here's a question. If the Spider Queen takes down the towers and the gate, does the team still get the experience?
I believe so. Oh, spider just nailed Johanna.
Goodbye, Johanna. And Zul, what's going... Oh, we get a hook! We get a hook! Doom Monkey has redeemed himself, and they're going to lose this keep?
Yeah, this keep is gone, and it's a fort.
Oh, fuck off. Whatever.
The building. They're losing a building.
They're losing a pyramid thing with spires on and shoots laser beams.
Yeah.
We're getting a Die for Vision turn in here. Will they have enough?
Four more they need to go.
And somebody has four. Li Ming.
Yeah.
Get him in there.
But But she's, you know, if she sticks out too far, she could get burst very hard by this combination. So they gotta
play careful. It definitely seems like the assassins are doing well. They've got more kills and they have a full level lead.
Yeah.
So that's gonna help them. Which, you know, I guess the spider queens have helped with that.
That fort up top was essential in collecting that one level lead for them. But it's gonna be very interesting how this goes, because ProtoMen is gonna be sitting at level 10 very soon here, which is gonna then allow them to be very dominant in the team fights for about a full level.
Yeah, for sure. What sort of heroics are you expecting from ProtoMen, Ben?
Banshees from Raynor, Phoenix for Kel'Thas, Tranquility for Malfurion, Go for the Throat for Greymane, Stitches. The general pickup is Putrid Bile, but I feel like he's going to do the eating one, and I can't even think of what the name of it is.
Yum, yum, yum. I need to say, I do like Die for Vision going for a team fight right now. While there's, you know, there's a level gap, but they don't have their heroics, so you might as well try.
Yeah, you're on the Li same Ming's, talents, that's when to do it. Li Ming's gonna get this turn in.
Get it, which is what she needed to do. She should get away from Greymane.
Yeah, but he'll poke him.
He does some damage, but not enough. So, I mean, that was a great turn in for Die for Vision, for sure, because they need something to push back the tens.
Yeah, give them the time. Them. Yeah.
Exactly. So... I mean, it'll be interesting to see if they get much tower push and if they get to a fort. It looks like top lane's just going to town. Nobody's really contesting it, so I would assume that's going down.
It'll at least get the front wall. And it looks like we've got two members, Zul and Johanna, wrapping up to try to take advantage of that while ProtoMen's defending down at the bottom.
Yeah, and it looks like Die for Vision will get their heroics very quickly here, which will help in the team fights. Anything major you're expecting heroic wise from I mean, you could just look.
I was gonna say they're all there. I'm kind of surprised. It looks like Gargant is picked up on the side of Nazebo, which is interesting. They tend to be Ravenous Spirit that's picked up, just because there's better damage output from it. I personally like Gargantuan just because it is so much time out.
Oh, Johanna. No, that's... She'll be okay.
She'll be okay, yeah.
She'll be all right. Yeah, it's very interesting.
Yeah.
You like Gargant because it gives you a friend and mm-hmm. you don't have to pay him.
Well, in something like this, it's a nice... Oh, nice go for the throat on Greymane. Oh!
And he can keep going, too, because if he gets a kill with it...
Yeah, it resets.
It just keeps going. And he gets a Li Ming.
Yeah, nice that pickup with his Gillian cocktail.
Beautiful. He's got to get out of there now, which he will do. Definitely a great play by Kamakaru Kitsukautu.
Nice.
I said that wrong.
Stitches
whatever.
Did pick up Putrid Bile. So just to give them the kind of capabilities in the fight to slow people down, zone them out, that sort of thing.
Yeah, ProtoMen should definitely get a turn in here, which looks like Raynor will do. I hate to say it, but it seems like there might be a bit of a snowball here.
Well, this map can be very snowbally because of the fact that as your spiders are pushing lanes, you're easily able to collect more gems while your the other team's on the back foot not really getting to collect gems because the spider queens are in the way. But you can turn it around. So.
Oh, for sure. It's never too late. We haven't seen any camps picked up yet, which is... They've been very busy team fighting and keeping their lanes pushed. Die for Vision's been a little bit on the back foot. And man, this fort right here is definitely just... This is done. Yeah.
And I'm thinking, while they're pushing forward, the bottom... Nazebo will be able to push this back, but again, they're losing a front wall, which is just more experience in ProtoMen's bag to keep that level advantage.
Yeah, for sure. It definitely looks like they're actually going to go for the second wall. Which makes sense. We have Raynor throwing down his...
Hyperion?
Yeah, which definitely pushes him back, which allows the Spider Queen to do some damage, which is nice while they rotate bottom.
Yeah.
To try and catch the Zoo or...
Nazebo.
Mm-hmm.
And with Stitches probably having his hook ready to go if Nazebo pushes out of this.
Get out of there, Stitches.
Ooh. Oh!
That hurts.
Doom, that you overstayed hurts. Your welcome slightly there.
Yeah.
Isn't it bad that I'm just kind of waiting for the comment from Doom about him sucking?
This is terrible. And if he doesn't, Doom, That was terrible.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
So, speaking of camps, we've got both teams rotating towards them.
Yeah. I mean, I know you like to take camps a little earlier if it arises, right? There was a lot of team fights, so there wasn't really too much
time. No, I think if anybody would have backed out early, neither team has anybody that I would say completely excels at taking camps quickly early game. It's not like we have an Illidan or anything like that in the game. So it's important to stay in those team fights and not let your team fall behind.
Definitely poke Zul there. What are you doing? Let him turn those 22 in. Kalthus definitely should have thrown something out there. I thought, just to annoy him at least.
The longer you can delay them, the better. And Li Ming, this is going to give Li Ming the opportunity to turn in and get that last one for the Webweaver wave.
I know they're trying to get that bottom, but I think, I mean, Zul had 22.
Yeah.
Right?
You don't want to leave them to turn that. If you can stop them from turning in without dying, it's probably the best course of action for you.
I mean, it's different if you have to jump in there. Goodbye, Johanna.
Yeah. And we've got Greymane on a rampage.
Just going there. But we do have Lili. Oh, bulls are
boy.
Back.
Nice root by Malfurion.
Goodbye, Lili. And look out, Li Ming, because they got your number. So they did get the turn in, though, the die for vision. So they will have the Spider Queens pushing, which will help their level and a half disadvantage.
But I still think with having two down now as the Webweavers are spawning, this will give ProtoMen the time to clean up at least one and a half Webweavers before the other two get back into the fight.
It's most definitely not going to be as effective as it could have been. Yeah, yeah. Bottom Webweaver gone melted already. Who cares, right? Here comes the middle. Greymane, he does some major damage. He doesn't want to lose those 26 gems, though, so he might play a little more defensive. Don't know if he'll be hitting his wolf form too much, just, you know, staying back. So there goes the middle one. Really did no damage. And then they'll just get the top here.
Which will secure a keep, it looks like. But that's not the end of the world, with still a level lead.
Interesting Hyperion. My god! Goodbye, Zul. Goodbye, Stitches. Goodbye, Malfurion.
Kalthus needs to get out of there.
Jeez, goodbye, Kalthus. Jirger's
done.
Holy shit.
Very nice fight on the part of Die for Vision there. Great burst damage that they put down. Nazeba was spreading his DOT, which was great. Li Ming. That was greedy, girl.
That was definitely greedy. Sure, they took a lot of damage there, but come on. There was no point for that, don't think. But
you lose some gems by doing that. You give the team more experience. They've got now picked up 16s on the side of ProtoMen. So that talent advantage for about a half level now, which will give them a bit of a fighting advantage. This is 16 is probably about the third best talent tier, where you hit a power spike, so you don't necessarily want to be giving the team it if you don't have to.
Yeah, and it does look like the Spider Queens definitely didn't do a whole lot to change the level advantage or disadvantage. They are getting a bit of a push here, but, I mean, getting those towers down has helped, though. So they've closed the gap a little bit with the Die for Vision. But, I don't know. The next team fight could really make or break either team, I feel.
Yeah, I completely agree there. I love how Kalthus is just hiding off to the side, trying to get some good damage in on the assassins, not jumping ahead too early.
Chased out of there by Nazeebo. And will they get Johanna? Li Ming. Li Ming, Zul, get out of there.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Malfurion's got to get something going on. We're going to lose the Stitches. We're going to lose. Just outside Li Ming. You got to. See, this is where the assassins are—they're having trouble. They're just so squishy, and I don't know if Malfurion is the best healer.
No, it's, but I don't know if there's anybody that would be amazing in this type of situation that can put out that much burst damage. Maybe Lili with her jugs would be the best pick. Everybody likes good panda jugs.
That just got weird, but okay. What do you think about Karazim there? I mean, you don't want to group your assassins all together.
No.
But he does have a bit of, you know, they don't have to be right next to one another to get the heals.
It could work, but again, I don't think it's enough sustained heals. Because you would get one burst, and that would be about it.
I guess it depends on the build, right? You could get the double burst, but still, I don't know if that's enough.
Even if you get the double burst, that's not going to bring them back from dead, especially with the damage output that the Poison Nova's getting. That, you know, Zul has been doing an amazing job of landing that right in the middle of the teams.
Yeah, it does look like the teams picked up their objectives, which is great. We have Die for Vision pushing in center lane, definitely closing that level lead. This seems like this is ProtoMen's game to lose.
Yeah, but it could be that they've lost their spike in advantage.
For sure.
We've got some posing by the boss up top.
Interesting.
Hey, ProtoMen, they're going boss. Maybe.
A minute later.
I do like how Die for Vision is all riding on the Billy Goat. I like that.
Yeah. Synergy. Cool. Synergy for the win.
Woo! Yeah, I mean, ProtoMen got up there. They, you know, expected that they were going for boss, which, you know, now was the time. It was bold because everybody was up. We lost the Malfurion, which is not good for ProtoMen.
Yeah.
Yeah, this isn't looking good.
We're going to lose a Lee Ming. Main kill. And we might get a Zul here with... Come on, Greymane.
Get a Zul. No, that's it for Greymane, too. Oh! Lose a Greymane. We did lose a Zul as well.
Yeah, the Rainer ult coming in over top of that really helped. So a 3-for-2 trade in going towards Die for Vision side. Again, we've like also... you said, it's their game to lose for ProtoMen. The level gap's been shrinking and shrinking. And
well... ProtoMen, or Die for Vision, sorry, has taken a lead in the levels.
Yeah, they just pulled it out, and they were able to get a Webweaver turn in there.
So I would assume bottom four, it's definitely gone.
Nobody's there.
I mean, ProtoMen has pushed bottom lane pretty well, but if Nazebo goes down there and clears it, I think it'll be...
Yeah, Nazebo can protect the Webweaver well enough that it should get close to the bottom fort. Especially when we've got Lili and Johanna both wrapping down. They know what they want to take.
It's a good play by ProtoMen. They notice that their top lane was pushed the farthest, so they go after the top Spider Queen first.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, they're going to take some hits here no matter what, so you just got to do your best. They got to go in as a team, though. You know, Malfurion, you're slipping behind, buddy. You don't want to go into this... solo by any means.
Well, and especially with the lockdown from Zul, right? If he can cast that Bone Prism and catch somebody that Lee Ming can just pick off, GG.
It's absolutely a deadly combo.
And we don't see... I was curious if the Zul was going to pick up the Vulnerable. I believe that one's at level 13. That the allows him... You know, it's basically like allowing somebody to completely burst whoever's in the Bone Prism.
Crazy. So, you know, it seems like the double specialist seems to be working.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it'll be interesting. The die for vision definitely has, I mean, they've got half of their gems, so they can get a turn in, or partial turn in.
Partial turn in. But ProtoMen have a full turn in, right? And they, change.
They got to be careful, though, because Die for Vision has their 20s. Mm-hmm. So, goodbye.
Oh, that good save with Malfurion there.
Yeah.
Greymane's going deep.
Totally, Greymane. You got to be...
Go, Greymane. Go, Greymane. Go. Go, Greymane. Go, Greymane. Go.
He'll get her, but will he get out? No, he won't get her. Oh, Greymane.
Greymane.
That was sheer desperation right there, and he lost a decent... amount of gems. It looks like they're going for a turn in,
which is good. Capitalize. They've got a one-man advantage now. Get the turn in. Get some pressure. Bottom lane's pushed really nicely for them.
Yeah, it seems strange that, you know, bottom lane was pushed all the way back, and it seems like bottom lane's just doing extremely well for some reason.
Well, they still had Siege Giants there.
Well, that would do it then.
They make a significant pushing power in the lane.
Yeah, look, they're clearing lane, which you got to do right now to help that Spider Queen get up there. But, I mean, it also spreads them out, which you don't particularly want to do. I know you have a person lead, but it,
Yeah, that's interesting.
I mean, I guess it's Zul and Lee Ming. They're your lockdown and kill. So,
Good hook on Nazebo. You don't want to be caught out at this point when your team's a little behind. He's going to get away.
That was a great little defensive wall that he put up there.
Yeah, with the Gargantuan. Nice job.
Yeah.
But it is allowing them to get this front wall down.
Maybe. If Stitches doesn't screw that one up. That was very close, Stitches. You got to back out, man.
He's doing his job. He's staying in the front where he should be.
Yeah, that was a nice Phoenix by Kalathos. Definitely a defensive one, which was, nice
to see. Defensive, but still allowed them to poke the wall
down. To do some damage. They've rotated bottom to get this keep, because it's not a fort. Thank you, bud. It's giving them 21s, which will help a bit, but at the same time, this could really all come down to a team fight right now.
We're at 22 minutes already, which means, yes, it could definitely come down to a team fight. You pick off a couple people, the death timers are long enough that it's obvious the other team will be able to capitalize somehow on it.
Yeah, they're getting objectives, which makes sense. Johanna looks like she's going bottom just to clear lane to help things out a little bit, speed it up. Zebo's got to watch himself. He's just up there by himself. He's not in a very aggressive position, but
it's good to have somebody up there. You can see what the other team's doing, get an idea if ProtoMen's going. That's a very aggressive Lili.
You don't want to face check with your healer, but I don't think that paid off.
Oh, it definitely didn't.
This is putting
Die for Vision in a very, very big spot, and they literally died for Vision there. Johanna's level 20 trait has been popped where she gets unstoppable. She's dead. Handsome Man's dead. They're one person up for the next 40 seconds. I feel like this one might be GG with Bruisers pushing in.
Yeah, they can definitely do some damage.
Zul have his ult up so he can try to push back as much as possible.
They still have full health, though.
But with three assassins, full health, and pushing in here, so there's the poison over to try to force them back.
Yeah.
But blows him up. Malfurion's able to burst heal over this. And this is going to be GG.
Yeah, and both teams know it.
Yeah.
We have a gray main B-stepping, doing whatever he does over there.
He must have heard me earlier.
Yeah, so that was that.
Good game, guys. Definitely
well played. We will pick a winner.
Make sure you hit the right one this time.
Yeah. Who won, Ben?
That ProtoMen! Was ProtoMen! So nice
congratulations,
job, gentlemen.
ProtoMen.
Nice job.
And let's take a look at the stats. Who are you calling for MVP? Oh. Ben's busy typing.
I'm actually just going to have to jump. We do have another game right
at 8
o'clock.
Okay, bye, everybody.
We can. I love the Gray Mane. He was going hard.
Yeah, Gray Mane did some cool things. I liked he was in there. He was in their face. And that was good. I liked that.
Yeah.
So, beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know who we're casting.